A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 8th April, on the front page you have President Ibrahim Soli's MDP heads for a landslide in Maldives. So this is regarding the elections in Maldives. The parliament, which is called the Majlis, had its elections and the early results gave the party in power 60 seats in 87 member Majlis. So this is the party of the president. On page 7 you have about 85% of Ujjwala beneficiaries in 4 states still use earthen stoves. So this is a study which recommends the scheme should move beyond benefits for women alone to change household behavior. So this is, you can see that it is said only 27% households in the sample states reported exclusively using LPG to cook food a day. So this here you can see those who use only LPG, those who use earthen stoves only, and those who use both. So the those using both is quite high. You can see in Rajasthan it is very, very high. So this is regarding the Ujjwala scheme, Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, to provide, you know, LPG connectivity in homes. Then below you have one more official in each booth will cut VVPAT delay. So opposition parties have now filed a rejoinder to Election Commission in Supreme Court, and they say that this delay can be cut if there is one more official in each booth. So the Election Commission had submitted before the Supreme Court that if VVPAT counting takes place as per the demand of the opposition parties, that at least 50% of the machines should be randomly, physical verification of VVPAT slips should take place in each assembly segment or in each assembly constituency, then in such case there would be exactly 5.2 days delay in vote counting. But now the opposition parties have filed a rejoinder saying that this delay can be reduced if there is one more official in each booth. Then next is jolt for BJP as man dies in detention camp. So this is regarding the detention camp for foreigners in Assam. So here a 70-year-old Bengali man has died in the detention camp. So this news has come forth. And this is parties seek credit for enclave exchange, but citizens say their plight is far from improved. So you should know about this enclave exchange which took place between India and Bangladesh. So in West Bengal's Kuchbihar district, there are many such enclave settlement camps, and the voters here, you can see, are not happy with the conditions so far, even after the enclave exchange. You can see the detail is provided here. 51 Bangladeshi enclaves became part of India and 111 Indian enclaves merged with Bangladesh. So this is actually territory, land. So enclave means a land piece which is surrounded on all sides by another country. These were enclaves of Bangladesh, but they were within Indian territory, surrounded on all sides by India. So such enclaves, people living here, it was difficult for them. It's not administratively possible for them to be governed by Bangladesh. So that is why we had this enclave exchange, in which you can see 922 people living in erstwhile Indian enclaves came to India. So those who were living in enclaves of India which were in Bangladesh territory, those people also came to India. So of course there was more burden on India, but this historic land swap took place, you should know about this, of 2015. And below you have no end to discoloration of river Periyar in Kerala. So it is said, residents say that pollution control board is not paying it enough attention. So you can see the color of the river is changing. Water turned pitch black in one stream. It was milky near one region. So this is a problem which is being faced here in River Periyar. So it provides drinking water to Kochi city, and it's a cause of worry for the residents. On the editorial page, the first editorial is capital high. So this is regarding how to retain the confidence of foreign investors. Macroeconomic management has to be, high. So that is the key to having, maintaining confidence or retaining confidence of foreign investors. That's spoken here. And this is, the heat is on. So it says local administrations must draw plans to address heat stress and possible water scarcity. So with climate change and even below average monsoon in 2019, so these steps are required. Heat stress has to be addressed and there will be possible water scarcity. And the lead article is the governance dashboard. So this is regarding current regime, how it talks of how it has failed to deliver on its promises of development and clean government. And this is when a new era dawns, what's in a name? So this is regarding Japan. And Japan's emperor Akihito is abdicating the throne and the country gears up for Reiwa era. So here you can see the emperor when he abdicates. You know, it will end his era and you can see that there will be a new era. Akihito's coronation happened in Jan 1989 and it is called Heisei era. So the Showa period of his predecessor ended and now you can see it was the Heisei era which again ends when he abdicates his throne. This is again regarding Japanese internal developments. You can skip it. Then this is regarding if Gandhi were alive today. So it says, considering his view of politics, he would have privileged civic virtue in elections. So it is said, Gandhi is perhaps more relevant now than ever before for our understanding of elections. On international page, you have Libyan commanders, rebel force, launch strike on Tripoli. Tripoli is the capital of Libya. So there's fighting between two camps happening here, which has so far killed 21 people, according to the government. This is a conflict which has shook Libya. So here you can see an airstrike took place and the UN-backed government vowed a major counter-offensive now. This is Libya, which is an African nation, North African nation. And this is Rwanda, again an African nation. So Rwanda is a family again, 25 years after genocide. So this is President Paul Kagame of Rwanda. He says the country is more united than ever before. So 25 years after more than 8 lakh people were slaughtered in a genocide that shook the world. This is the statement coming forth. There is this Kigali genocide memorial to here located. So this was a conflict between the minority Tutsi population of the country with Hutus. Then below you have Netanyahu pledges to annex West Bank settlements after polls. So this could sound the death knell for two-state solution. So this is what Israel is preparing for. Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has pledged to annex settlements in the occupied West Bank if he wins the elections which are to be held. So this is a deeply controversial move that could end the idea of a two-state solution. On page 13 you have high on emissions. This is a coverage on the demand for fuels, how it has increased worldwide. You can see for coal, oil, gas, renewables, how much it has been consumed across China, US, India, Europe. You can see gas is in the negative and even coal in the negative. There's no oil consumption in Europe. It is renewable energy which is emphasized on. And then here you can see carbon emission peak. So this is regarding the demand, the new demand coming forth. And this is carbon emissions. So here you can see because of coal-fired power generation, other coal use and other fossil fuels. And this is regarding the clean energy push. So this is a growth rate for renewables. So here you can see for India too, the growth rate is high. And this is regarding electricity generation through renewables and their growth rate. So here you can see coal growth rate is quite low. Even gas has come down. And for biomass, wind, solar, the growth rate is quite high. Then on the last page you have fungus immune to drugs is secretly sweeping the globe. So this is regarding Candida auris, a fungus. So it is said that germs like bacteria are growing resistance to drugs. So here a case of a person, elderly person in US being suffering from this is in news. Plus also in South America, in Africa, India, Pakistan, this Candida auris has swept through. So it is said that fungi just like bacteria are evolving defenses to survive medicines. So this is an important health issue now. Then this is Swiss protest over global warming. So tens of thousands of people demonstrated in several Swiss cities against climate change. Around 50,000 marched in all, in demanding, you know, and raising a voice on climate change. So this is it. This is again regarding artificial intelligence robots may assist soldiers in the future. So scientists in the US are developing artificial intelligence systems that could help robots assist soldiers in the battlefield. So scientists are looking at ways the dynamics of human brain may be coordinated to predict behaviors to optimize team performance. So predicting behavior of the individual soldiers may help create more optimized team. So that is being researched on. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com and enroll for the course. And also you can download the PDFs there. Thank you.